Well, hello. Welcome back to Fitness Friday with Johnny Tiger. On January 28, 2022, we're going to continue our workout, basic workout with a resistance band. This is like remembering what we've done before. At least I think we've done a lot of these before, but it's always good to have a refresher course. And today we're going to switch to the hardcore power band. Last time we did this, last week, we did it with what I call the wimpy band, because this was the tube band with handle on it. Today we're going to use the long power band, my personal favorite. Why? Because today we are going to do five exercises. All of them require you to be standing if you can. So using a longer band like this, it's both more work, but at the same time, easier to do when you have to stand. Like, I can do this with a wimpy band, but I will have to get on my knee because the wimpy band just doesn't stretch that long. So if I'm standing, it wouldn't be able to, wouldn't work. Okay, so just so I can stay standing without having to go down on my knee, we're going to use a power band. So let's get started. Exercise number one, overhead press. We're going to get the band under both feet. Remember, if you have balance issue, you might want to find a nearby wall to lean your back against. So, okay, get the band under the arches of both feet. Stand with feet shoulder width apart. Okay, now grab the other end of the band with both hands. Your hands should also be about shoulder width apart. Raise the band to your chest or shoulder level. Stop here. Okay, this is your beginning position. From here, without arching your back, push straight up to the ceiling. Remember, when you work with a resistance band, nice and slow. We'll do 10 of these. Okay, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me give you guys a different angle. By the way, when you're doing this at home, I don't recommend you to move without releasing the band. I do this just because I'm doing the video and I sort of know what I'm doing. Okay, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, I want to quickly talk about this. When I say don't arch your back, it's because a lot of time when people are straining to lift something over their head, look at my body position. What's going to happen is they'll reach with their chest. So their back will lean back. There's going to be a curvature in the spine, okay? That shouldn't happen when you do overhead press. If that happens, you're doing too much resistance. Got to do it lighter. Okay? So it should be back totally straight, relaxed, push up with your shoulder and arm only. Okay? There should be no arching of the back. Right? Number two, stand up row. Again, the band will be under both of your feet. Hold the top of the band with both hands. Again, hands are about shoulder width apart. Your palms should be facing your body. And this time you're pulling from your groin, down here, that's groin, up to your collarbone. When you pull, you want to bring your elbow back, your shoulder blade back. Imagine you're pinching something between your shoulder blade as much as you can. Okay, we're going to do 10. Ready, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to switch angle so you guys can see the profile. 5. Watch how my elbow go back every time. 6, 7. I'm going to switch angle again so you can see me from the back. 8, 9, and 10. Since we have a band under our foot already, our feet, we're going to keep it there for this exercise number 3, which is bicep curl. Okay, bicep curl, you'll start with relatively the same way as the previous two, except this time you're going to have your grip facing upward. So your hands are holding the top of the band. The band is under your feet, feet shoulder width apart, hands shoulder width apart, but your palms are facing up, like you're picking up a barbell. Okay, nice and balanced. We are going to keep our elbow glued to our side and lift, okay, and curl. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to switch angle. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, when you do bicep curl, you want to keep your elbow and upper arm as still as possible. A lot of people, when they're working with too much weight, what we're going to see when they do the bicep curl is they'll swing the whole arm forward and then down. They'll swing the full arm forward and curl. Okay, that's defeating the purpose. They're using the momentum. Okay, so the upper arm should stay as still as you can, elbow as close to your side as you can. That elbow is not going to move from that spot. You just curl. Curl. If you watch my upper arm, barely moving. Exercise number 4. Now we're going to change our stance. Now the band is only going to be under 1 foot. So you guys can see I'm going to start with my left foot. I'm going to go into a forward lunge with my left foot forward and the band under my left foot. With the band under my left foot, my left foot forward in a forward lunge, I'm going to pass the other end of the band to my right hand. So the band is stretching across diagonally. And I'm going to lean forward and put my left elbow on my left knee. Okay? And this is my position for the whole thing. Okay? Now, with my left knee, my left leg forward, the band under my left foot, my left elbow on my left knee, the band, the top of the band in my right fist, I'm going to bring my right elbow back and out so my right arm is parallel to the floor. And from this position, I'm just going to straighten my elbow. This is an elbow kickback with resistance band. Okay, so your upper arm should be relatively parallel to the floor. And you're just moving your elbow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Changing angle so you guys can see. 8, 9, and 10. And we're going to switch side. Okay, so we stand up. Going to a lunge with our right foot forward. the band, go under our right foot, past the top of the band to our left arm, our left hand. Lean forward, put my right elbow on my right knee, bring my left elbow back so my upper arm is parallel to the floor. And here we go. Standing kickback, tricep kickback with the resistance band. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Chin chin angle. 7, 8, 9, 10. We got one more to go. And the last one is also a tricep exercise. This time it's an overhead tricep extension. So we're gonna stand up straight or upright, feet shoulder width apart. I'm going to have the band under my right foot. And the other end of the band is held in my right hand. Okay, so one end is under my right foot, the other end in my right hand. And from here, I'm going to pull the band up to my ear like it's a cell phone. Okay, and hold it here. That's my starting position. Okay, the length of the band should go down the outside of my arm, not inside, not like this, right? It should go on the outside. From here, keep your elbow where it is as best as you can. Straighten your arm toward the ceiling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Change in angle. You can see that band kind of slipped there a little bit, so be careful with that. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, we switch side. Band go under left foot. The other end go into left fist. Bring it up to my ear. Make sure the band is on the outside of my arm. And straighten my arm using my tricep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, changing angle, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Again, I want to stress that when you work with a resistance band, you want to move nice and slow, okay? So, for example, while I'm doing my tricep, I'm not going like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay? Can I move that fast? Sure I can. But would that be really getting me to exploit the all I can from the resistance band? Would I benefit from the resistance band fully? No, because resistance band is for slow exercises. So when you want to do this, you got to think 1 or 2 seconds up, 1 or 2 seconds down, up, down, up, down. Okay, no jerky movement. That's it, folks. 5, very simple. Upper body, mostly arms exercises with your resistance band. We got quite a few more we can try next week and the week after. So hopefully that'll give you guys something to work on this weekend. We'll be back again tomorrow for Survival Saturday with Johnny Tiger. For now, have a good night.